Yes, people, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are all doing well. So what a day it was at Old Trafford in the Manchester Derby. A 2-1 win for United, and it did feel like at one point all hope was lost. But all hope is never lost with Ten Hag and this Manchester United team as we fought back to get a 2-1 win. A little bit of controversy along the way, but I don't mind about that because it just means a few more tears from the Manchester City fans and, of course, Boovy. And I absolutely love that little fact. I don't mind winning a game with a little bit of controversy when it's against your rivals. It always seems to rile them up a bit more. But the stats, when you look at them, 7 consecutive wins since the World Cup return, 17 scored, 2 conceded, 9 consecutive wins in all competitions. We have lost one game since losing to Manchester City at the Etihad. That was against Aston Villa in their first game under Unai Emery. With 7 wins, 1 draw at Old Trafford in the Premier League since that defeat on the opening day of the season, we are making Old Trafford a fortress again. 5 clean sheets in the last 7 games. Our defending is much, much better thanks to Erik ten Hag, and all is going well in the cup competitions too. It all seems too good to be true as a Manchester United fan at the moment, and that's why everyone is talking about whether we are in a title race. We are 1 point behind Manchester City, who are battling with Arsenal, who are obviously ahead of them in the title race as we speak. We play Arsenal after the Crystal Palace game, so everyone is hyping it up. But are we involved in a title race? I'll answer that question in this video. Before we do that, make sure you're hitting that subscribe button, liking, commenting, sharing, etc., etc. Now, what the manager said was, the fans may dream, but we have to keep our feet on the ground. He said, when asked about a title challenge, don't do that. We are not even halfway through the season. It's only January. There's a lot to come. A lot of gaps in our game we have to work on. And that's one of the things that I agree with. I don't think Manchester United at this point in time are in a title race or should be thinking we are in a title race. Of course, it's lovely the position that we're in and the run that we're being on. And of course, the goal or the hope or the dream is to always win the league. And we hope that Erik ten Hag can get this team in a position that we can challenge for the league. But if we were to win this season, the title, it would be, you know, way ahead of schedule. And when you look at Erik ten Hag's squad, we still have some very big holes in it. Whilst it's great to see the likes of Rafael Varane, Casemiro, you know, Marcus Rashford absolutely performing fantastically well, Bruno Fernandes as well. You know, there's players that I haven't mentioned that are performing well. But whilst all those players are performing well, one injury to Casemiro and we're relying upon McTominay and Fred again. You know, Eriksen, you know, he's looking tired at the moment. We clearly need a midfielder to kind of rotate in and out with him. Anthony Martial made a Weetabix, so he keeps getting injured. We need a striker. Yes, we've brought in Wout Weghorst, but he's not the ideal long-term solution to the problem that we have. We still haven't got Jadon Sancho back in the team. You know, we could still potentially need some fullbacks, although Aaron Wan-Bissaka has been excellent since his return to the team. So this team still has quite a few holes in it, do you know what I mean? And you could maybe even look at the goalkeeper situation as well as one that maybe needs addressing. So all in all, this Manchester United team is far away from where Erik ten Hag would want it to be, the squad. But what he has done is got the team together again. He's united the fans and the team together again. He's got us fighting for every single game. Tactically, he's spot on. And I know he's a manager that would rather dominate in possession and positionally on teams. But in this instance, you know, at times, he's going, actually, I know that maybe I haven't got the players to always do that, so I will tailor my tactics in order to get results. And that's important as a manager as well. How many managers have we seen that have a style of play, but they don't have the squad to match it, and they keep going with their style of play because they don't have any other way of doing things? And I think Erik ten Hag has been fantastic in, you know, his first season in the Premier League. Tactically, he's very rarely got it wrong. And I think he deserves huge, huge credit for that. We even saw it in the City game. Excellent in the first half. I thought he coached a team that should have been leading at half time. Then there was that spell where we see Manchester City come back into it, get the goal. Then he makes a few changes and things work out for United. And he has that in him. He has the patience. He has the clinicalness. He has the, you know, the sight to be able to make those changes. And I am absolutely delighted with him in terms of the way he's got the team performing on the pitch, in terms of the way he's got the players fighting for each other, fighting and united with the fans, the way he's got everything feeling good again. Old Trafford is now a fortress. But are we in a title race? Not in my opinion. No, not yet. Let's relax a little bit. If we get to April and, you know, we're 3 points off top spot, then we go, you know what? Maybe something could happen here. But to think about that in January, when not even half of the season's been played, when we've still got huge games to come up. All right, we've played City twice now, got 3 points out of six against them. Still got to play Liverpool. Still got to play Chelsea. Still got to play Spurs. Still got to play Arsenal. Still got some very difficult games to come up in this season. As well as the fact that we'll have a few injuries. An injury, touch wood, it doesn't happen. But an injury to Casemiro or someone like that. United have got huge, huge problems. So I don't think it's right to say we're in a title race right now. But who knows what could happen as the season goes on. And the way this Man United team is playing, it wouldn't surprise me if this run went on. Because we are performing fantastically well. But just have to have a little bit of wariness in the fact that it's still a team in transition. It's still a work in progress. There will still be bumps in the road. We could lose against Palace, lose against Arsenal. And everyone's going crazy. And the same people that are saying we were in a title race are saying Ten Hag out and all this madness. So just relax a little bit. Let's enjoy it. Let's enjoy the football. Enjoy the games. Let them not talk about the title race. And let's see where we are in April. And maybe in April I'll be saying those three sweet words again. But I'm not saying it yet. Because Ten Hag's cooking something. But he needs time. He needs to let it marinate. And I believe that he will be the one to bring the title back to Manchester United. But probably not this season. Do you know what I mean? Despite how good we are playing. The squad still needs to be better. He still needs to be backed. And maybe he'll get that backing in the summer. Another quote that I love from Ten Hag was, "This is why I came to Manchester United. This club is a monster. Old Trafford is a stadium with the right vibe. If you manage to light the fire, you get an amazing experience." And he has lit the fire and gotten an amazing experience. We've beaten City. We've beaten Liverpool. We've beaten Spurs. We've beaten Arsenal. We are the only one out of the top six, the big six teams that we haven't played yet at home is Chelsea. So we're beating those big boys in our own gaff. Can we go to Arsenal and beat them there? Who knows? Maybe we'll be looking at things differently if we do that. But let's see. Let's just enjoy this for now. Keep watching highlights back and everything. It just feels good to be able to do that again, doesn't it? Ten Hag, I absolutely adore you. But yeah, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Am I being too sensible? Are we actually in a title race? Let me know in the comments below. See you in a bit.